Welcome all. Today we will see Rio Declaration Part 1. It was held in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil from the 3rd to 14th June 1992. When you see its goal, establishing a new equitable global partnership through the creation of new level of cooperation among states which are key sectors of societies and people. What is the outcome of Rio 1992? Rio Declaration on Environmental and Development, Agenda and the Forest Principles. Convention on Biological Diversity, Framework on Convention on Climate Change, United Nations Convention on Combat Desertification, important legally binding agreements, Rio Convention were open for signature. See into the principles. Human beings are at the center of the concern of sustainable development. They are entitled to a healthy and a productive life in harmony with nature. Principle 2. States have, in accordance with the Charter of the United Nations and the principles of international law, the sovereign right to exploit their own resources pursuant to their own environmental and developmental policies and the responsibility to ensure that activities within their jurisdiction or control do not cause damage to environment or other states or area beyond the limits of their national jurisdiction. Principle 3 talks about the right to development must be fulfilled so as to equitably meet developmental and environmental needs of present and future generation. Next is Principle 4. In order to achieve sustainable development, environmental protection shall constitute an integral part of the development process and cannot be considered in isolation from it. Now we will see Principle 5. All states and all people shall cooperate in their essential task of eradicating poverty as an indispensable requirement for sustainable development. In order to decrease the disparities in standard of living and better meet the needs of majority of the people of the world. Principle 6. The special situation and need for developing countries, particularly at least developed and those most environmentally vulnerable, shall be given special priority. International action in the field of environment and development should also address the interest and need of all countries. Principle 7. States shall cooperate in a spirit of global partnership to conserve, protect and restore the health and integrity of the Earth's ecosystem. In the view of different contributions to global environmental degradation, states have common but differentiated responsibility. The developed countries acknowledge the responsibility that they bear in the international pursuit of sustainable development in the view of the pressures their societies place on global environment and of the technologies and financial resources they command. Now we will see Principle 8. To achieve sustainable development and a higher quality of life for all people, states should reduce and eliminate unsustainable pattern and production and consumption and promote appropriate demographic policies. Principle 9. States should cooperate to strengthen endogenous capacity building for sustainable development by improving scientific understanding through exchange of scientific and technological knowledge and by enhancing the development, adaptation, diffusion and transfer of technologies, including new and innovative technologies. Principle 10. Environmental issues are best handled with the participation of all concerned citizens at their relevant level. At the national level, each individual shall have appropriate access to information concerning the environment that is held by public authorities, including information on hazardous material and activities in their communities, and the opportunity to participate in decision-making processes. States shall facilitate and encourage public awareness and participation by making information widely available. Effective access to judicial and administrative proceedings, including redress and remedy, shall be provided. Next, principle 11. States shall enact effective environmental legislation. Environmental standards, management objectives and priorities should reflect the environmental and developmental context to which they apply. Standards applied by some countries may be inappropriate and unwarranted economic and social costs to other countries, in particular the developing countries. Principle 12. States should cooperate to promote a supportive and an open international economic system that would lead to economic growth and sustainable development in all countries to better address the problem of environmental degradation. Trade policy measures for environmental purposes should not constitute a means of arbitrary or unjustifiable discrimination or disguised restriction on international trade. Unilateral action to deal with environmental challenge outside the jurisdiction of importing country should be avoided. Environmental measure addressing transboundary or global environmental problem should as far as possible be based on the international consensus. Principle 13. States shall develop national law regarding liability and compensation for victims of pollution and other environmental damages. States shall also cooperate in an expeditious and more determined manner to develop further international law regarding liability and compensation for adverse effects of environmental damage caused by activities within the jurisdiction or controlled to areas beyond the jurisdiction. Principle 14.